Hello everybody, my name is Hutch and this is finally the last part of the Nikon Z9 autofocus speed test series. In this video, I will compare the Nikon Z9 with the Nikon D500 while coupled with this 600mm f4 lens. Deciding to get a 600mm f4 lens was not that easy for me because I already had the Nikon 500mm f4 VR lens. Plus, it's a big investment and also lots of load to carry around. The 600mm VR Type G or FL lens are just out of my price range. And although the Nikon 600mm Type D version 1 is cheaper and built like a tank, it also weighs like one. So instead, I settled on the 600mm f4 Type D version 2 lens. It is a great lens. 600mm is actually a great focal length, as long as you don't plan to run around chasing the subject, and if the subject is not too close, because this lens have a minimum focusing distance of 4 meters. I did this autofocus speed test to learn more about the capability of the Z9, but also to know what kind of setting should I use with particular lens with certain situation. And I hope that it will help you as well. Just a quick summary of the setup. I was using my bird book as my test subject at about 6 meters away from the camera. If you want to know more about the setup, then please have a look at the part 1 of this series. I will put a link in the description below. The speed test result from the 600mm f4 is actually very similar to the result from the 500mm f4. Without teleconverter, the Nikon D500 actually autofocus as fast as the Nikon Z9. With teleconverters, the autofocus speed of the Nikon D500 actually drop proportionally to the power of the teleconverter being used. As an f4 lens, it is actually working pretty well with the 1.4 teleconverter. However, once you attach the 2x teleconverter on it, the autofocus become too unreliable, too slow, and you are only limited to the center autofocus point. So I would not recommend it for a real life situation. The Z9, on the other hand, is a complete different story when it comes to a teleconverter. The autofocus speed stay more or less the same no matter what teleconverter you attach on the lens. Yes, there is a little bit of slowdown once you attach the 2x teleconverter, but it is still faster than the Nikon D500 coupled with 1.4 teleconverter, so it is still very usable. I'd like to mention as well that all the tests that I did was actually made with the firmware 3.01 version. A couple of days ago, I upgraded the firmware to 3.10. I did not redo the measurement, but I was playing around a little bit with the camera, and actually I noticed quite some improvement in the autofocus. For example, with the 300mm 2.8, now the Z9 300 2.8 combo does not hang anymore. It searches for the subject more actively, it is now focusing in a kind of a two-step way. I think, in my opinion, in the first step, the camera kind of moved the focus plan in a way that the image is not just a complete mess of blurred things. And then afterwards, then in the second step, the camera fine-tuned the autofocus or identified the subject. It's already an improvement, but I wish in the future firmware, Nikon will manage to remove that little tiny pause between the two steps of the autofocus. It is also interesting to note that the autofocus speed of the 600mm f4 is actually as fast or maybe as slow, depending on your point of view, as the 200 to 500mm VR lens. My test setup was quite far from a real life situation because I defocused the lens completely and then focused to almost the close minimum focusing distance. And that might actually put the 600mm f4 lens at a disadvantage because the focusing motor have to drag the focusing element from infinity to the minimum focusing distance. In addition, we should bear in mind that this is actually a more than 20-year-old lens. And the real advantage of a prime lens is actually that extra stop of light and the quality of the image that you get from them. So to conclude, the Nikon 300 2.8 is still the king when it comes to autofocus speed, especially if it is coupled with the Nikon D500. The question is then, where is the bottleneck preventing the Nikon Z9 to use the full potential of the 300mm 2.8? That only Nikon will know. So if you don't mind to do lens calibration and you don't need animal detection or in-body stabilization in the camera, and you also don't plan to use more than 1.4 teleconverter, then I think a camera like the D500 and the D850 are actually still a good value for what they could do. Especially now that people are moving to mirrorless camera, the price of those used D500 and D850 actually dropped drastically. So I think it's a good time to pick one if you don't mind to use them. However, if you feel bothered and annoyed by autofocus fine-tuning and you want that animal detection function, you might also plan to use more than 1.4 teleconverter on your lens, and then I definitely would recommend the Nikon Z9. Maybe some of the specs of the Nikon Z9 will be implemented in the near future's released Nikon mirrorless camera. But for now, I think it is the best mirrorless camera that Nikon produced. So that's it for this Nikon Z9 autofocus speed test series. To be honest, it was quite long and not the most fun to do. I'm glad it's done now, but I think it's still useful, and I hope you also find it useful and interesting. In future, I will do something more fun, gonna go out and take pictures, real life situation, and I will share my experience with you. So until next time then, bye.